Oh, mind that dog, John. Mind that dog.
Had a bit of an experience with a dog down at Big Joe's recently. Almost healed up, but he's friendly enough, isn't he? Right, mate? I'm getting too close. Looking for a sack trap here at JM Fishing Park today, Christmas Eve. So, a bit hungover, went out with Oz, Oswaldo the Great, and met his wife Evie yesterday. We had a long old day. Dad's out to talk me into fishing today. We got a couple of big parties tomorrow and the next day, so and the beat goes on. Looking for a sat track here. We used to transport the gear down to the lake.
Getting a truck, aren't we?
Yeah, can't find a sat track. We're not going to fish too far. They're going to try the first bit. See if we can catch some fish on the bottom today.
Down there.
Got the up in the water rods. If we do try, want to catch a Siamese, which seems to be the best method here. Dan Zach's rabble of a rod bag. Little Lizardo special. There's a rod bag I've won up in Bangkok.
Nice, isn't it?
Absolute belter, yeah. Milo special. Try the cage feeder today, fish a bit lighter. Be lovely to get a Migral, Hovens, or a Juliens would be the
Black Shark Minnow.
Got the net.
Black Shark Minnow as well.
Eh?
Black Shark Minnow, isn't it?
Black Shark Minnow, yeah, forgot about that. Jenny wants some tilapia to cook for the girls for Christmas Day. Got the tips, very lucky with this. I left the, don't tell Tony Locke, but I left his tips on the back of the truck. On the bumper. And stopped at 7-Eleven and got some bread, and they were still there, luckily. They didn't bump her off.
I'll just film you while you get all the gear out and take it down there, shall I?
No. These are basically the fish you can take home. Tilapia, Java or silver barb, Rohu, Esok, Barramundi, Bacapong, type of gourami there, Ballet, Sand Goby, Babul, Featherback, Cyclone Featherback, Bagai, the walking catfish, Baduk, and the snakehead, Bachan. All the other fish got me returned to the water, which is great, because they got some nice fish in here. It'd be a shame to see the likes of the Hovens carp, the Siamese carp, the Black Shark Minnow, the Migral, and another nice fish that are in here. Give them a chance to grow, so it's a good vibe. We're fishing the top end. It's unusual, a lot of fish rolling here, possibly swai. There's a few Thai anglers down the bottom end, so the swai will very often push away into an area where there aren't anglers, so I would have thought these will probably leave us in a minute once we start fishing, which is fine. It's good to see fish in the area, topping. Got to get Jenny a couple of tilapia later on, so we got some worms. Try and get two or three of them to take home, pay by the kilo, and pretty much how it works. They've cleared a lot of weeds. It used to be a lovely, lovely bank of like bulrushes here, which have been cleared. A bit of a shame, had a nice character. Net in the water there, look. Lots of shrimps and little fish here. This one's got a lot of little dead fish in here that have obviously been in here a little while and somebody's forgot about it. Bit of a shame. One's alive there. These are the baby gourami of some sort. Looks like the shrimps are having a crack inside. Maybe they put them in there dead to catch the shrimps.
Possibly
and probably.
Yes,
says Dad Zach. And he's possibly and probably right. But we're gonna have a crack. Come on, it's midday. Let's get some rods in.
There's a look down the lake. As we are on the top of really quite a high embankment here. John's over there, about three pegs down the lake. We haven't really fished much at this end of the lake, so be good to give it a try today on the cage feeders, method feeders, even maybe the waggler. Have a go on that. Little restaurant area, lovely food here as always, beautifully kept place. And I'm gonna go to the toilets. Have a look at the toilets here, awesome. you know, so nice brushed concrete finish. Hello. Decent toilets. Decent sit down toilet. Very nice. Spoiling us. Oh, Harvey's opted to fish this side. He's going to fish a cage feeder, I think. I was just saying, you're going to fish a cage feeder out there.
Yeah.
Got sort of mid across, halfway across, or maybe.
Right over them.
Yeah.
Walk over and chuck some bait in a minute.
Yeah.
Sort out where I'm casting, so it'll be at the base of that tree probably.
Yeah.
Fished here before on a cage feeder, practicing for the plantations match, and fishing in the middle for about 3 hours, never had a touch, went over and had five nice rohu, lost a decent one, and then hooked a big fish at the end, probably a Siamese carp. Tried to land it on the platform down there, which they've made for photographing the fish, which is nice, cages and platforms and oxygen, so we're having a go here.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he broke me come the end of the fight, probably got a bit, I hadn't fished light for a while. Different approach here today, we're going a bit lighter and fishing on the bottom with lighter tackle. Might hook the old fish and lose it because we're fishing a bit lighter, but hopefully not. There's some good sort of 60 odd pound Siamese carp in here, which we've had. You've still got a chance, even with the 6 or 8 pound line. But it'd be lovely. A 12 pound Juliens would be awesome.
Juliens, Black Shark Minnow, Migral, three species there. Yeah. Or Hovens even, the mad barb.
It's hard, it's difficult.
There's not many in it, is there?
It's not heavily stocked, which makes it interesting.
Yeah.
40 baht.
Can't beat it, can you?
Can't go wrong.
Yeah. Nice one. Let's do it. A couple of cups of coffee, get us going as well. Nice one. Oh, hello. Just first cast. We just put the rods out on the bottom, the big rods. And
making a mess.
Harvey's making a mess, but he's got a fish on. That's the main thing.
Feels like a solid fish. He swam towards me. It could be Julian. Disturbing some fish there.
Which net do you reckon you need?
Big net, no, mate.
Big net, yeah.
Quite solid.
Yeah.
Might be a big swy. Come on. Come on, the Julian.
Be a lovely start, wouldn't it?
Yeah, got it. Got a movement like a Siamese then.
Yeah, I reckon it is a Siamese, to be honest with
you.
Yeah, they hooked that right off my spot as well.
We won't talk about that.
John cast out. And I had the whole lake to cast, and I sort of cast
about 2 foot. 2 foot, that was generous. Under our own bank, he was actually in close. I hooked it and he went out into the middle. Big swirl.
Siamese, mate.
I think so.
Definitely.
Hopefully it'll be my first one out of jam off the bottom.
Yeah.
Danny Townsend, we was having a Christmas dinner with him yesterday, and he had 2 lovely Siamese carp off the bottom here last week or so. Him and his boy. Down on the bottom at Books Around at the moment.
Christmas. Who is?
The fish are down on the bottom.
Oh, okay, right? Right, yeah. Good
stuff. Maybe they're with the cold weather feeding a bit deeper. Wet season's long gone.
Had it on about 10 minutes now. So 10, maybe 15 minutes.
This is
nearly done.
Nearly done.
There is.
Hey. Bit of an abnorm.
It's okay, mate. That's right.
Yeah.
done, Zach. Super stuff. Whew. We'll wander down to the cage. I'll grab the scales.
Oh, it's a surprise, mate. 35 and a half.
Is he?
Yeah. Oh. Nice fish.
Yeah. Wow.
Do you want me to go and grab your camera as well? Get some stills or...
Yeah, go on then.
Go. Give her a bit of water.
Ooh, yeah.
Very nice. First fish, first cast.
Not bad, is it?
On bread punch.
10 minutes in the water.
Lovely. Very nice. 35 and a half pound. Right, mate. Nice first fish there.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, chuffed for that. Blew the cobwebs away. First one I've ever had off the bottom here, so that's a nice little bonus. Unexpected, really, so quickly. Nice overcast day. So we get a few more.
See that.
Leave that here, right?
Yeah. May as well. We need it again.
Woo! That's Axter.
And there's the scene.
There's the rig, very simple. Scaled down, one of Danzak's flatbed feeders. We got off Lazada, 15 grams that one, packed on. Some 80 pound braid, one of me homemade weights there. Solder wire wrapped around a cotton bud, melted each end. Quite a long hair to house quite a big bit of punch that swells up quite big in the water, and a hook that's probably a size tie size 10 probably, something like that.
Yeah,
and
about a 6 or 4 UK, isn't it?
Probably would be, yeah. And you pack the feeder just at the end, just trap that in there a little bit on the top, hopefully he's down there, something like that. Cast over to the bottom of the far shelf, and it worked.
Yep, let's do it. Let's have another one.
Come on, let's do it. Leave the scales and the stuff here, shall we?
Yeah. Some sort of eagle over there, I don't know if you can see that. It's been circling around. It's quite a big bird. I don't know what kind of one it is though. That's our thing.
Fishing a very standard UK cage feeder, as simple as possible. A couple of stopper to stop it sliding down the line when you're baiting it up. Three stoppers there, I can move them about, probably 18 inch hook length, tiny bit of lead, a couple inches from the hook, a couple of bits of punch, and hopefully it's popped up an inch or so, and we're hopefully casting to about 2 meters from the far bank. Short again. Jibbing out a bit, getting some bites, deep there. Sun's just starting to poke out, isn't it?
Mmm, lovely. Let's go and get another crap. So, John's got a fish on first
went,
fish.
Went to wind in and struck just in case there was feed left in the feeder, and he was on there, swam at me, and classic Rohu sort of.
Not a bad crap. One.
Fish maybe 4 pounds. Lovely. Should get a few of these fish in this method.
Nice fish,
though. They love the far bank. Slightly shallower water.
And this must be the most common fish that we catch on videos.
Yeah.
Decent size one, isn't it? A chunky one.
Lovely. Silver bullet.
Hello. Hello.
I heard an alarm there.
There's an alarm going off. There we go. I'll investigate that.
Quite high up here, so we'll drop it back in the net.
Let him go up. Lovely. What up, buddy? Last one, mate. Two fish down.
Yeah. Well, we were 100 baht and biggest fish in most species, didn't we? So, happy Christmas.
Yeah.
To me.
Yeah. Oh, we've just had a screamer. Just reset the rod. Absolute screamer. Do you want me out of the way?
Sure, yeah. Another side of the
Yeah. He's smashing it at the moment. Yeah, pretty much. Is that your second cast, is it?
Third.
Last
one didn't have those. Might be working. I'm not sure. Actually, no, it might be over. Turn back.
It's alright at the moment.
Yeah.
Did he get the other fish out of there?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, the chap's just removed the first Siamese from the cage.
Yeah.
Really sure the benefit. I suppose if it struggled, you could sort it out and know it's in trouble, possibly. I could have done with a bit of oxygen. The other one seems to have oxygen in it. This one doesn't. That's a huge swirl. This could be a good fish, you know. Gonna need a bigger platform.
Mm-hmm.
Just had a glance. Definitely a Siamese. Similar size to the first one. Is he 35?
35 and a half.
35 and a half, there he is. Crazy really, yeah. The local anglers are eyeing up, casting a bit closer to where we're hooking these fish now.
Yeah.
Quite a common trait. Better than Dan doing it.
I said, so am I. Mine up your spot. Get a bit closer. If we cast. Good fight.
Going well.
Stamina this one, isn't he?
Yeah. Nice on the Carita. The light gear, yeah. 2.5 test curve, 2.5 pound test curve, so that. Good fun.
Yeah.
Siamese don't usually look for trouble, even if bugs them around. They do go around the post, but I think it's accidental. They don't look for it like the Mekong do.
Yeah.
Red tails, the ripsaws, even the Paku and the Tambakia will look for trouble.
A trail of bubbles going along there, then.
Where?
Along here. There was a trail of bubbles going along. There was, like a fish moving. Something, was it, what would, is there anything, the breeze bubbles in there? Giant, what are they called?
Featherbacks?
Featherbacks, yeah. Like one of them.
Definitely featherback in here. Seen them roll. And they're up on the board.
Yeah. It's always a giveaway, isn't it?
Native species, yeah.
Well, I've only ever caught a couple.
Yeah, there's
one. Yeah.
If you fish worm,
we'll have to go have a go on a worm in a minute.
Often you catch more, you know.
Yeah.
They're a predator.
It's coming up, there he is.
Yeah, not massive.
Not massive, no.
Not so. There's only 25 in here. Well, lovely, really. Amazing that you catch so many.
Yeah, they've certainly come on the feed the last few months, haven't they?
Yeah.
But they've got to a certain age and mainly feed on naturals.
Yeah, could be. I mean, there's not a lot of feed goes in here, and the size they've got quite quickly is incredible. But a lot of it's down to the fact that there's a low stock density.
Good testament to the quality of the water.
Yeah. Lovely colour, isn't it? You can see there's a lot of plankton.
Yeah.
Feed naturally in the water.
Oh, he's disappeared, so shall I get it in the sling?
Yeah.
There she blows.
That's mustard.
Well done, mate. Well done. Superb.
Buddy.
Come on. Buddy. The Danzak.
Nice, mate.
Yeah.
A bit bigger than that. 40, 42, 43, I reckon, maybe.
There you go. Lovely. Yeah, not much bigger. Certainly would do a few dinners if you were taking home and eating them, wouldn't it?
Certainly bloody would,
might flip back in there, John. There we go. Somewhere around 40. Bit of luck. Yeah, in the region. Oh, yes. Oh. 42. Lovely. So it's really bouncing around a lot.
I'm happy with that. Fucking yeah. Shattered.
Yeah.
Shit. I don't want a still shot, maybe.
Zoom into your little little thing.
There we go. Little necklace it's from Oz and the Hash Boys yesterday at the Christmas dinner. Well, it's been a struggle, hasn't it, Danzak?
Mm.
Danzak saved the blank with a miniature tilapia. Lots of little taps and touches, but looks like we've got another metal-y sock. All in all, hard work, apart from the Siamese on the big rod. Not a little fella. Middle of the barb lip, classic. The old Guru QM1. Lovely little, almost like a circle hook. Little fella. Lovely. Fish look quite lean at the moment.
Yeah.
The winter vibes. Slowing down, maybe. Yeah. Gotta keep going, keep casting.
Yeah.
Getting to that time. I don't know if we're going to have a late one.
Mm.
We might have a couple of beers somewhere, mightn't we?
Yeah.
Cheeky.
Yes.
Last one. Ah, the end of a lovely day's fishing.
Cheers, mate.
Good dance, Zach. JM Fishing Park. We're sat in the... What do you call it in China? Rickshaw.
A rickshaw, yeah. Big one.
Bloody big one.
Yeah.
Interesting day, hard. It's been cold. Even the Thai anglers packed up, went home quite early because they realised it wasn't going to happen. Chipped away. Danzak had a massive tilapia. It had to be inch and a half.
Yeah.
I thought you'd correct me then. Well done.
That's a bit bigger than that.
There you go.
Coverage.
I had a couple of lucky Siamese right at the start, took the bait within 5 minutes of it being in the water. 35.5 pound and 42 pound, I believe it was. And two Rohu. Lots of little nudges and bumps on the cage feeder, cast right across. Whacked 10 feeder fools in at the start and then fished over it. Lots of little nudges and that. A lot of fish were up in the water, I believe, with the cold weather. Maybe fishing up in the water might have been more productive, but we wanted to try and catch a Juliens, a Black Shark Minnow and a Migral, which generally will feed on the bottom. So best chance of catching them is fishing on the bottom. Another good sort of bit of advice for coming to Thailand and you want to catch certain species, you've got to aim at certain levels of the water for them. If you want to catch Siamese carp, especially in the water like this, very often up in the water will give you more chance of more fish. But on the bottom, you catch everything on the bottom.
Yeah.
And just not today. We've had a lovely day. It's Christmas Eve, a couple of beers. Might stop Pat's bar around the lake on the way home. Don't tell anyone.
Yeah.
And we'll see what happens. We got a couple of action-packed days planned around at James Rule, aka Chubby's house tomorrow for a house party, Gert Spit Roast. And then around at Libra Force Butler's house on the Boxing Day for a few more beers and revelment. Danzak's getting a cheese board for tomorrow. It'll be lovely. I'm doing some spuds and some bread sauce, not really with pork, but a lot of people have never had it before, so I'm going to give it a go. Just rambling now. Happy Christmas to everybody back there or all around the world.
Merry Christmas. Christmas.
And let's hope 2021 is not so much of an abortion as 2020. All being well, everybody who comes out generally for the high season will be able to come next year and we'll be able to get some more vibes on, a few matches and some fun and frolics.
Yes.
Look after yourselves and tight line vibes. Do it with the other beer. Yeah, that'll do.
Tight line vibes.
Yeah.
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 put.
Yeah. Late at night.
Yeah.
They got stumbling up fear after a few whiskies and a few pints.
Yeah.
It's Christmas Eve.
It should
be frosty, should it? I should be laid on my back doing a piss fountain at this moment.
Quite cold, right? Quite cold.
Mm.
I think it's about 26 degrees.
Is it?
Yeah.
Sounds cold, mate.
Yeah.
I bet they'll be gutted in England.
Yeah.
Here he is.
Yeah.
He's back.